Hi, it's been a while reviewing your Reddit submissions.
There is no engine that can run on burning water. There, I said it.
Okay, boomers, if you have questions with quality, post it on our subreddit, no matter your entity. I may or may not check it in the next episode of LATITY.
Okay, let's see. Oh, by the way, thanks to Kiwico for sponsoring this video. More about them later. Is this real? Found this guy welding with graphite. Let's see. He's taking the graphite out of a battery. A zinc carbon battery. He connects the graphite to a 12-volt battery. Makes sense. Oh, now this was bullshit. Yes, the graphite does get very hot and maybe you can solder with it. It's just making some tiny arcs here and suddenly you have a nice clean welder. Material is added there. He just welded the two pieces with the proper welder and then showed that, hey, I'm... But maybe we can make a makeshift soldering iron out of it. Here is a graphite or carbon rod I pulled out of my carbon zinc AA battery. And I have a spare soldering tip that is begging to turn on hot. And lucky for it, my rod perfectly fits its hole. I set the power supply to 10 amps and connect it to my soldering thingy here, like so. Like so. Now it's heating up, yep. Oh, it's just 2 volts at 10 amps, a little bit more than 20 watts. I guess we could go higher. But look, works like a charm as a poor man's soldering iron. 12-year-old Mehdi. Ha, look at me. I posted this on Twitter. For my birthday, I got this electronic kit, which was a 5-transistor FM radio and a bunch of money that now are probably worth less than a cent. At 12 years old, I had no idea how that kit worked. I just enjoyed the fumes of solder and the blinky lights and sound. My God, look at that haircut. Makes me happy I'm bald now. How? What? Rectify, please.
You record us. Alright, so... We got rid of the fan that was in the bathroom, as you can see, and installed this lovely new light. I thought I wanted everything exactly the way it was, but it's not functioning the way it did. As you can see, this light still
operates. The wife sounds very happy.
However, this light over here, this switch rather, over here, that used to operate this light, now turns on this light for some reason. And, as an added bonus, I can go back to this light, hit this light, and it gives it more power. You see that? For some reason. Okay, even better. I can turn this off.
Sorry, am I losing batteries?
Hold on, I'm turning this on and off, nothing's happening. I can turn this one on. I can plug this into the plug below this switch. And turn the light on. Via hairdryer.
But it doesn't turn the hairdryer on!
But it doesn't turn the hairdryer on. Here's low. Here's high. You see the difference? Look! Low, low, high. Low, high.
Sounds like a good puzzle. How can you screw up your wiring so badly that this happens? Okay, let's see if we can solve this riddle. So, this is how the circuit should be. AC line should go to a switch and lamp, which was previously a fan. Another switch and lamp and a power outlet where a hairdryer connects to. Now, in the faulty circuit, it seems turning on any switch, even the hairdryer switch, turns only this lamp on. How can we screw this up? I reviewed the video and filled a truth table which looks like this. We don't have all the data, but I assume lamp 1 is also on here and lamp 2 is always off. Basically, only when all switches are off, lamp 1 is off and lamp 2 is always off. Lamp 1 circuit is a logic OR circuit. So how? Answer in 3, 2, 1. So first, lamp 1 must have a much higher resistance compared to lamp 2 and the hairdryer, so they are more like a short circuit compared to lamp 1. So I say lamp 1 is LED, which requires little current to turn on, and lamp 2 is incandescent. Now all we need is to switch one connection only. Disconnect from here and connect that there. Switch 1 still turns lamp 1 on. Switch 2 through the low resistance incandescent lamp 2 also turns lamp 1 on. And the hairdryer switch also does it through the low resistances of the hairdryer. There might be other solutions too. Why am I not getting shocked holding a conductive metal rod in a fly swatter? Well, that's obvious. This is the guts of a fly swatter. And if I short the output, you see, it doesn't shock me because the high voltage is not across my body, but across the metal here. So there is no current running through my body. Never become a part of a high voltage circuit. Cookie boom? Oh my God, my dignity is something I would say if I had some. Ayo! My kind of stripping. Oh, wow, now that's some stripper. Maybe. If he touches the metal, he gets shot.
Rob! So we're timing you here. Okay, let's go.
Oh, did they make that thing? Oh, did they make the thing I made a while back? Did they copy me or I copied them? Let's see if I can find that show. Is it this one? Here it is. Seems like they uploaded it like 1 year ago. And my video was... How far back was it? Oh, there it is. These games will shock your kids. Back in October 2019, like 3 years ago. Now we need to find a sweet spot between harmless and lethal.
My idea is to
yes,
use a circuit.
This is the one I made back then. So they copied me. I should go ask them for some loyalties. Royalties. I mean, we mostly make things that aren't for kids. But if you want your family to learn something while having fun building, you better visit my sponsor, Kiwico. Kiwico provides these quality hands-on project crates, each one designed to stimulate curiosity and knowledge. Kids end up with results that are actually usable. A device, a toy, or anything in between. My daughter always enjoys putting some of these more complex crates together from the Tinker Crate. Let's pass her a new one. Hey, I have a crate for you. Oh, you're already doing a Eureka. Okay, carry on. Every month, you'll receive one crate to build with the first month free. Signing up from my link, kiwico.com/electroboom. Kids will learn science, art, engineering, and more through the process and the additional information provided in the handbooks. You can even get them as a gift for any children you may know. So do it.
Wow, that's a real lockbox.
Now I can store all my chocolate in here.
What, you have chocolate?
No.
200k, I'm waiting for clock. What? This is the way. Regular alarm clock, exploding capacitors. You would have to arm your alarm clock every night. Maybe we can make a magazine that auto-reloads the capacitors for the next morning alarm. 200,000 likes on this video and I'll make that. Oh, it reached 200,000 likes? Great. So if this video gets to another 200,000 likes, I'll make this. Okay, I'll make it. Mistakes were made. Oh my God. You melted the entire extension cord? How much current? How much current do you have to pass through that to melt it like that? Something I can try if I modify my microwave oven transformer. 100,000 likes! Well, I mean, those wires cost money, so 200,000 likes. Why does your microwave waste half its power featuring ElectroBOOM? Did you see this Science Asylum's video? Go watch his video. I saw his video after he posted it. Otherwise, I would have told him that his terminology may raise some angry mobs. This is the type of rectifier that is inside a microwave oven. And what it really does is that it shifts the AC voltage as much as the peak voltage value. Now, Science Asylum concluded that because the diode can only pass current in one direction, half the AC cycle is not used, which he said was wasted, but he really meant not used. And simulating this specific circuit, you'll see that the power supply in both positive and negative cycles is in fact sending current and power out to the load. So, sorry Nick, what can I say? Which reminds me, in my previous latitude video, I mentioned that the arcs jump the shortest distance, which wasn't very accurate. So I guess I have to rectify that now. What I really meant was that the arcs would jump the shortest distance in a perfectly uniform medium. And air, especially in short distances, is pretty uniform, so the arcs tend to jump the shortest distance. Like this. Pretty straight in short distances, but not very straight in longer distances. In longer distances, air is not very uniform, so the arcs tend to go in these random paths. But in a very non-uniform medium, that the resistance of the medium can be different from area to area, electricity goes the path of least impedance. This is an old one. This must be fake, right? Testing an electrified samurai. We don't actually know what is going to happen. They're not knowing what is going to happen. I'm sure they know what's going to happen. Nice. Well, I'd seen this video before. This is my buddy Allan Pan, and this is not fake. The box he's standing on has a Tesla coil in it, giving him very high voltage. And he has nipples for some reason. And of course, he's wearing a metal shield, and the arcs are jumping to that hoop, which I assume is a ground. So basically, no current is running through his body. This is Allan Pan with an LED as his heart. With the Tesla coil on, we can— Ow! Never become a part of a high voltage circuit.
You see, the current runs through his heart. Oh no, Pan is burning. Oh.
Pan burned, LED died. I'm putting a resistor parallel to the LED to protect it a bit.
Trying again. See? The electricity runs through his heart and it dies.
Now I place this wire loop around him to represent the metal suit.
And now the Pan man's heart is— Ow! And now the Pan man's heart is protected. Oh, no.
Basically, the suit shorts out all the electric fields around the body, and the potential across the body is zero, and so his heart is saved. I think this would be good for a rectifying video.
We have modified this engine to run on water only.
Ooh, running on water.
Will it work?
Let me save you the headache. His motor supposedly runs on burning oxygen and hydrogen generated from electrolysis of water, powered by the electricity from a battery that is charged from a dynamo that is turned by the motor. And there is extra electricity to run power tools and such. What is this perpetual garbage piece of sh-?
The next time someone tells you that water motors are a fantasy, show them this video.
Shut up! Why I see noise in my camera when I open the cap of this metal box? Ooh. Wow. And I bet doing that, later you'll have some noisy children too. Why are you giving yourself radiation poisoning? What's wrong with people? It's clear there is radioactive material in that lead container. Lead is a metal that can block the radiations. That's why when they want to hide something from Superman, they put it in a lead container. Well, we had enough fun for one day. If you still like these latitude videos, then, well, slap like now! And continue posting your interesting stuff to my subreddit, and I'll hopefully check them in the future. Have fun!